Hey y'all, Pastor Peter here again. Good evening. I don't know if you are, but I am a fan of Star Trek. And I've been a fan ever since the classic Star Trek with Captain Kirk and Dr. McCoy and Spock. And I love Star Trek when the New Generation came out when I was in high school and college with Captain Picard and Will Riker, Data, Deanna Troi, and all of that cast of senior officers in Star Trek. And I just want to say that one thing that disappointed me about Star Trek was the Generations movie. Now, I love the Generations movies, and I loved all, or the Generation movie, I loved all of the movies ever since Star Trek The Next Generation had all of their movies. And unlike many people, I actually liked Insurrection, and I liked every one of their movies, including First Contact and Generations. But one thing that disappointed me was the fact that if you think about the plot of Star Trek Insurrection and what actually happened, how Captain Picard and Captain Kirk joined forces to defeat Soren, the enemy, you realize that there's a logical problem. And the problem is the fact that everyone on the Enterprise is dead, and Captain Kirk is actually probably still alive, and also Captain Picard is of course still alive, but all of the Treks, all of the movies, even including Captain Picard, or I'm sorry, Star Trek Picard, the series that's going on right now in its first season, is all fake. It's all a fiction in that fictionalized storyline. And this is what I mean. Remember the whole story of Generations? The whole story is that Captain Picard couldn't defeat Soren himself. Soren fired a missile that caused the sun to go supernova, and the supernova would then force this Nexus wave that's flying through the galaxy to go towards the surface of the planet that Soren fired the missile from, and it enveloped Soren and also enveloped Captain Picard. And that was Soren's whole point to begin with. He wanted to destroy the sun. He didn't care about how many people died on that planet, the indigenous life that was there, including the Enterprise, which just had crash landed. He just wanted to go back into the Nexus, because the Nexus is a place where you can have everything. You can be your own god. You can. It's like a holodeck. You can do whatever you want for as long as you're alive in there, or possibly for eternity if the Nexus can actually keep you alive forever until the Nexus itself dissipates or dies, whether or not the Nexus is a sentient being or not. And so Soren wants to get back into the Nexus because he just can't handle life without the illusory fantasy world and family that he doesn't have anymore in the real world. So he wants to just always be in the Nexus, even though it's destroying and killing the lives of millions of innocent beings. He's okay. He's willing to do that. And so he's the bad guy. And so Picard wasn't strong enough to stop him. And so he's now in the Nexus, and he sees Guinan there. And then Guinan gives him the advice that, well, why don't you go back in time and find someone else to help you, like Captain Kirk. And then he goes and finds Captain Kirk, and then they join teams. And because Captain Kirk is a better fighter than Captain Picard, Captain Picard is sort of more of the brains and Captain Kirk the brawn, they're both able to defeat Soren, the planet, and the solar system that they're on is saved. Unfortunately, Captain Kirk dies, but Captain Picard survives, and on continues the story of the Next Generation for the next several movies, right? Well, no, because here's a logical fallacy. They're still in the Nexus. It's not like the Nexus has the ability to send you out of itself. It can't do that. Because think about it this way. Some people will argue, yeah, it can, because that part of Guinan who still existed in the Nexus sent told them that they can actually go out. But if that's the case, then don't you think that Picard and Kirk would be smart enough to go further back in time, be transported further back in time to, or actually Picard doesn't even need Captain Kirk, right? Because all he has to do is ask the Nexus, or wished the Nexus to transport him all the way back to the first time he meets Soren and just stun him right there and get rid of him in some way or some form, so that this whole plot of bad events wouldn't happen anymore. Or if he wanted to, he could even go further back in time to resolve anything that he could, all the way back throughout history to whenever he wanted, or if it's his own life, whenever he wants, maybe back to when he was young, and basically rectify whatever problem that he felt that they had, or he had back then, or whatever historical problem there was, he could have resolved it. And so the story, it was illogical, first of all. I mean, they could have done that. Second of all, he's still inside the Nexus, right? Which means that the next story, I think it was First Contact, and the story after that, the movie after that, Insurrection, and the movie after that, the one where he had his Romulan clone doppelganger, and now the series, it's all in his mind, because he's still in the Nexus, which makes the Next Generation series after the movie Generations completely ridiculous and absurd. And so that is one of the beefs I have about Star Trek. It's great until you get to that point and you realize, oh wait, everyone's dead. They died on that planet when Soren caused the sun to supernova. So anyways, I don't know if you guys have ever thought about that, or if you're Star Trek fans, but I'm sorry, but from my point of view, Captain Picard is still in the Nexus. He's living his own fantasy right now, currently, through the series Picard, Star Trek Picard. And all of our favorite characters are dead. Data, Deanna Troi, Worf, Dr. Crusher, Geordi, all of them, they are dead. So think about that. God bless. Bye-bye.